Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of the Porsche 912e motor rebuild. If it's your first time catching us up on this is the second video in the series of tearing down my Volkswagen Type 4 2.0 motor that came equipped in the 1976 912e car, but I have a 1967 short wheelbase, long hood coupe 912 that I took a 912e motor of a 76 912e. I know it gets confusing, but case thing, all you know is that it's a Type 4 2-liter motor, stock, nothing special. The only thing we changed on it 4 or 5 years ago was hydraulic lifters, just because of the pain in the ass to adjust valves in a 67 car. Anyways, this is video number 2 of the teardown. First video, we got through the taking the tin off. This video, we're gonna finish up the tin, we're gonna get the muffler off, and we're gonna pull the head, and we're gonna finally find out why cylinder number 4 had no compression. And I'll just give you a sneak peek. Ready? Ready, ready? Bam, bam, bam. So you can see. You wanna find out why? You're gonna have to check out this entire video. It's long, but that's okay. So if you're into Volkswagens, into Porsches, air-cooled cars, give me a like and a subscribe. Comment down below what you guys drive, and sit back, relax, pour yourself a cold one, and enjoy an hour and a half of wrenching on a Volkswagen Type 4. Let's go. What do you think? Did it work? Let's find out.
So today, see if we can get that muffler off. Actually, we should have a good, that heat exchange is where I want to get off. Get that off here a little bit. Yeah, that heat exchanger is on with a nut right there. No. Ah, it's not that. It is a heat exchanger hooking up to the fan housing. That's what it is. There's one heat exchanger. Now we have better access to this head, which is what we're after. We really want to pull that head off and see what's going on with cylinder number 4. Before we get too started, I want to pull that. Is there tin? Yeah, there's tin right there. So we gotta pull that wire and I'll see that here in a minute, guys. So this piece of tin here. That just come out just like that. I'm a little worried about getting that
exhaust off only because I don't have to anyways. I guess it doesn't matter. So 13 millimeters. Oh, we're hanging out right here. Thought I'd just screw these in. So this side here goes there. So I'll just take this off so I don't lose it. I had a few of these head studs, exhaust studs, spin out on me. I had to repair a few of them. This is one of those. Yeah, they took the whole bolt and everything out. This is one of those, it's 8 millimeter on one side and 9 on the other, what I believe this was. So then, I'll try to grab this one. That's right, that one there, I'm gonna need a crow's foot for. So for some reason, can't get to this back without a crow's foot. Oh, and it's not even tight in there. Luckily. Another one. There's that. So, seriously. Come on. Damn it.
pulled out. There it is. All right. Now, there's a retaining spring in there. The spring. Which holds all those tubes into place. Okay, hold on to that spring. Dirty those are. That's a good time to probably replace all the seals in this. Let me grab, I have hydraulic lifters in there. All right, so number three here. Eleven. Yep, 11 mil. Nut in a washer. Nut in a washer. Stay. See her stay. There's number three. Three is out. Take care of number four here. Out of there, it looks like it was fully torqued either. Okay, here comes four. Number four is out. Make sure I keep my push rod tubes. They are the lightweight hollow ones. Okay, so I take a box, back of the motor, front of the motor, number four, number three. I know exactly where they're gonna go. I cut holes in there just like that. Okay, then set that aside. All right, with that done, we can now pull those tubes out. They shouldn't be in there that hard. Almost. There she is. Black on that side, green on that side. Let's take our time here. Place all the seals when I'm just trying to put this back together. There it is. All right. We are damn near there, folks. So we got to take off the tin on the bottom. There are two screws that hold it there and there, and then one here. I believe that is a flat head. Yep. I think the amazing Type 4 guru, Jake Raby, says to save it because it's a very special screw. So we will put it off to the side. Let me get a... Let's see now. I'm afraid I'm going to strip those out. Damn, those are good. So, pussy blaster on. There we go. make sure it falls anywhere, so. Do this again. Give it a little love tap. There it is. All right, so now this tin should come off. Yeah, one little leaf. One leaf. All right, it's now time for a head to come off. We can see just what we're dealing with here. My comments on what number four is going to look like. Oh, you know what? Before we get that head off, I'm going to take off this sheet metal as well. But there's a plastic tab there. Slip that off. Okay. Technically, I'm not going to take off that oil cooler and everything to get to that. I don't think that head's going to come out without that. I might be able to lift that out. Let's give it a shot. Okay. Brake and torque. How about some pussy blasters? And this over here. And one more to go. There's a bunch of washers too, so we'll grab those. I need a better magnet. Probably one I bought off of Harbor Freight or Amazon, I bet. And one more washer. All right. Let me readjust the camera here. No, I'm going to have to take that tin off. I know I'm, there's no way that head's going that way. Out it. And that means I'm going to have to remove. Well, looks like we're going to have to take this head off here. Okay, there's that front piece. All right, so back over. Two washers on that one. One washer on that one. That just holds that into place. This is the wire that runs to my I guess we're taking this all off. We'll pull these off, which I believe are a 13 as well. I'll do my 13 on that one. Are you being a good girl, Shears? I want to trust you, I do.
Okay, my three.
Those muffler bolts. One more. Okay, one muffler's off. I guess we will loosen up this bolt here so we can then take off our fan belt. That's an Allen head. One more on that back side right there. So let me move this muffler out of the way.
this one. Oh, lifter thought, that's right. Shit. I forgot about those lifters. Just one lifter. I might have to almost like a 10. Siri, what time is it? Hey Siri, what time is it?
It's 9:27 a.m.
That's not the right bolt.
All right. Now, film in here. Now we should be able to take that alternator, take this belt off. Okay, one belt's out. Never should have noticed that before. Technically, there's the tin for the alternator. That. We'll need a Phillips. There's a Phillips head that holds the rubber boot to the alternator for cooling. Sorry, there are some 10 mils. I think there are 9 mils on the back side of this. Probably could just take that 13 off right there. So this bracket here. More of that alternator. With that, put back on these real quick here. It's been a while since I've touched this alternator. It's like, you know, a year. Don't judge. right, so that one alternator, one wiring harness, and one fan shroud should come right out. Okay, well, now. I'm assuming we're gonna have to pull this off. So let's move you around. So get this fan off. Those are 13. Let's shoot some pussy juice in there. No, those are also Allen heads. One size smaller, as always. We always think we're bigger than what we really are. I don't have a flywheel lock I can use on this, do I? No, I sure don't. Let's see if my electric impact will take those off real quick. All right, we're taking a break. Okay, took a little break. I'm gonna go ahead and take these flaps off. There's just a little tab there, which I think all that does is kind of hold that into place. So it's inevitable. Take this off, it appears, but this should pop off of there. So I don't want to hurt the fan blades. But indexed. So we'll have to take that off to the side here. Just for safekeeping for right now. Now there's four bolts right here. And then there's the two side bolts that we've already taken out. So let's take off those four. I'm pretty sure those are 15s. Can't quite get that one out, but we'll grab them. Now, in theory, this should just pull right off. Okay. That goes the taco, which doesn't do anything for my 912E motor being in my 912. So I may just eliminate this whole wire in the future. So that's probably attached at the bottom. An associate about 4 or 5 years ago helped me actually do the rebuild. I do wedding photography, and so we did some horse trading. He agreed to rebuild my motor in return for shooting his daughter's wedding. So now if that's off, I do want to take just a second and just see if see it fall out. Oh, yeah, it did. There's that fourth one. Now let's see if this tin will come off, and that it will. There's that something. That's even a little rubber gasket in there. What? I like that. Okay. So I'm going to pull the tin over like so, and now I think we can take this head off without any problems. So let me just move the motor up. I'm going to spin this around.
Okay. Here's that moment of truth we were all waiting for. Okay, here's the moment of truth. That's what I'm seeing. Oh yeah. There is a hole in the piston. Lovely. Hell. And that's funny because that is the follower that came out. So it's definitely a piston issue. Let me get the camera. Right there, you see it? Big old piece at the top of that piston is gone. Pull back out here a little bit. You can just see right there, that's where she blew at. Okay, well, we got the head off. Lovely. Let me see if I can zoom out here. That's what we're looking at. Kind of look down in there. Isn't that cam? I don't see a lot of, too much wear on that. Oh boy. Well, what are we going to do next?